Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to our Lunch and Learn. We are excited to have you for this one-hour presentation today. Thank you for taking time to join us. I was just reading over Dan's bio, and this man has a wealth of information, so I'm sure we will learn quite a bit about the travel industry and where it's heading in its future. I'd like to now introduce our sponsor of today's program. That's Larissa from I Think Financial. And so with that, Larissa, I'm going to turn it over to you.
Morning, everybody. I'm Melissa from I Think Financial. Great promotion going on this month and for a little while for any referrals. If you guys are already members, refer friends, family, husbands, kids. You get $50 for every referral. So come on in, join the credit union, and then have your husbands, your wives, your sons, your daughters all sign up as well and go out for a nice dinner or order in dinner, I should say.
Thank you. So with that, I'll begin and I'll read Dan's bio. I've always done what I've always wanted to do is a quote often used by Dan to describe his career in the travel and hospitality industry. A native of California, Dan's passion and interest in the travel industry started as a young boy when visiting the Grand City Hotels of San Francisco, where he grew up. He loved the decor, luxury, energy, and excitement of those grand hotels, along with the personal care and attention from the hospitality staff servicing the high-end international clientele. He was in awe of the five-star service and facilities and knew this was something he wanted to do. This affinity for the travel industry led him to earn a degree in travel and hospitality management while working for various hospitality jobs to gain hands-on education. After college, he traveled extensively, visiting the grand hotels of Europe, to see and learn firsthand the art of fine hospitality. Upon his return, he started his full-time hospitality career working in hotels and resorts in California, Washington, D.C., and Florida, focused on conferences and events. In 1994, Dan left the hotel industry to start a meeting and events planning company so he could support his corporate meeting clientele directly in booking and managing their meetings and conferences around the world. To date, Dan and his staff have managed and been involved with over 900 meetings and events globally for thousands of travelers, emphasizing personal five-star care and attention to service. In 2006, Dan expanded his company to offer luxury cruises, tours, all-inclusive resorts, and custom trip planning with a personal touch. Dan loves to share his passion and experience with his clients on where to find hidden gems and destinations, along with trip tips, tricks, and skills to get them prepared for their trip. Dan and Emily hosts several groups trips to trips a year to Alaska, Europe, and the Caribbean that are open to everyone. He is certified meeting professional and has also earned many travel certifications from various travel suppliers. He is a member of the American Society of Travel Advisors, Cruise Lines International, International Air Transport Association. He's a member of our Chamber of Commerce and is also part of the Travel Leaders Network, which is one of the largest agencies and consortiums in the world. So with that, a man about town, as we could say. Dan, take it away.
Hello, everybody. Everybody can hear me. Hey, good to see you. Glad to be here with fellow travelers here. So if you're here, you're like-minded, you like to travel, great news. As Winston Churchill once said, we're getting close to the beginning of the end. The treatments, the testing for COVID-19, a vaccine is on the horizon. We now have some tools of which to travel. Let me show you here. We've got masks. We've got the sanitizer. We've got wipes. We didn't have this, in March. Remember that? We were fighting for toilet paper. We were fighting for paper towels. Now you have the basics. You can travel, add in a little disinfectant, and we can go out and start to see the world safely and healthy. We're going to have a little interactive session. I appreciate your spending some time with us today. I hope you're going to learn what's going on in travel and make you feel a little more safe on that. I also want to do a big shout out to Larissa at I Think Financial. I met Larissa at one of these talks with the chamber in March. I worked with a big box bank before for 35 years, yet they wouldn't give me the PPP loan the time of day. I met Larissa, her personal team and service. I got the loan here very quickly. So thank you very much, Larissa. With that in mind, let me share my screen and let's get into some travel here, guys. Okay, everybody can see this. So we're going to talk about inside the new way of traveling. So today we're going to help you arrive, thrive, and survive. We're going to talk about hotels, airlines, cars, theme parks, and cruise lines. I know Jonathan gave that bio way too long on me. Just consider me your personal travel coach. I haven't been everywhere yet, but it's on my list. Oh, so we have some poll questions, if you can help. We want to know what kind of travelers are. Jonathan, if you give me the first poll question, have any of you had to cancel or reschedule a trip due to COVID-19? If you could answer that, we want to be of help for you. If you could answer that, we'll give an answer here. So most of you have had trips that are canceled. This is very unfortunate. We've got a lot of domestic travelers, and 50% of you guys, it looks like, have traveled since COVID. Okay, we'll give you another 10 seconds here to get anybody else on here, and then we'll get rolling. Wow, 90% of you had trips canceled. Okay, well, hopefully we can help you out here. That's a whole other session dealing with future cruise credits and travel credits and rebates. Okay, thanks everybody for the polling. So why do we love to travel? We love to travel for adventure, to educate ourselves, to connect with everybody. Okay, we talked about that. So before traveling, I was always a luxury travel, love booking luxury travel. Before COVID-19, everything was high touch, high service. It's changed. High touch, high service, what do I mean by that? We have some beautiful resorts here in South Florida. So you drive up to the Porta Cachera, the doorman opens the door, greets you. They start to unpack all your luggage, including your child's teddy bear. Give it to the bellman who takes it to the cart. The valet parking attendant takes your car keys. He parks your car. Once you get to the resort, they greet you. They escort you to the front desk, make you sign some paperwork. You give your credit card to them. The bellman will escort you up to your room, unpack for you. Meanwhile, you've had maid service in the morning. You have maid service the night. They'll give the turn down mints. Real nice. Do we want all that now? Probably not. Other thing that's different on luxury service is it used to be at a beautiful hotel that retail, shopping were part of that, that you went to the spa. They had fine dining. You talked about with the maitre d' would personally sit you to have a sommelier. So not, that's all changed a little bit. Now it's low touch, limited service with emphasis on cleanliness. And you're packing your own bags and you're rolling them for you. So everything we're gonna talk about today is about the cleanliness pledge from our hospitality partners. Everybody's clean. We're all trying to get your consumer confidence up and going. We want you to travel and feel safe about it. It's not about the brand new Westin bed or on-time performance. It's about how clean we are. So let's talk a little bit of history, how we got here. This thing has disrupted travel more than anything. I've been in travel 30 years, a lot more than 9/11, more than SARS, more than the crisis with a mortgage in 2008. So quick little history on this. In December, or even before that, first case starts in Wuhan, China. And then we had that started to go out to, from there to the Philippines, to South Korea, Japan, Iran, Italy, Spain. January 30th, it was declared an outbreak by WHO. So we probably remember hearing about that when they were doing the impeachment hearings. Again, I'm not political at all, but a lot of this has to take place. They were doing impeachment hearings. We didn't hear much about this. They declared an outbreak by WHO. They didn't declare it a pandemic until March 11th. Pretty crazy, right? January 21st, first case reported in the USA. January 31st, the USA declares a public health emergency. They issued the first travel ban from China, and the Corona Task Force actually formed right then. February 4th, we all heard about this, the Diamond Princess cruise ship. That's the one that had the big outbreak over in Yokohama, Japan, right outside of Tokyo. It's quarantined for 1 month there. People are going a little bit nuts. What's going on out here? I remember I personally was in Grand Cayman with the whole program I was operating. We had a cruise ship out there. People were wondering what's happening. Surely it's not going to take place out in the USA or on little Grand Cayman. Little do we know. February 29th, we had the first death in the US. We issued travel ban from Iran. March 12th, they issued travel ban to and from Europe. And then March 14th, that's when everything fell apart. That's when the cruise lines hit a voluntary suspension for 30 days. The no sail order, now we still have not cruised since then. The no sail order is all the way effective until November 1st. 40 ships report cases of COVID-19. And we started to expatriate and bring folks back from Japan. We live in a great country in the U.S. Some people had to stay on those ships for a long time. They were not able to get back to their home countries. And that weekend, the CDC recommended no gatherings. First it was 500, then 250, and then to 50. And I'm like, oh my God, the business, meeting business, cruising, everything is just shot here. So more restrictions around the country, and we're basically in a lockdown. So how's that impacted travel? Sporting events canceled, the Olympics, NBA, Major League Baseball, basketball tournaments, theater shows, all live production shows are canceled, conventions. Personally, it's affected a lot of people for weddings, honeymoons, reunions, graduations, bucket list trips. There's billions of dollars of canceled trips. I know it's affected a lot of you via the poll, and people have, we've never had it in the travel industry where billions of dollars of future travel credits. It's almost like Bitcoin. So it's a new way of dealing. It's each travel supplier has their new way of dealing with that. That's a whole nother session of strategies and how to rebook, how do you use effectively your future travel credit, but you do want to use that. So most of the world right now is still on lockdown. We're starting to open up. So hospitality job loss, we'll just get into a little bit. It's been devastating. 40% of U.S. unemployment is in leisure and in hospitality. Despite the economy starting to open up, 25% of all hospitality workers remain unemployed. That's double the next industry. It really has hit our industry very hard. Half of the 16 million jobs in the leisure and hospitality sector were wiped out in March or April, so it got wiped out immediately. 65% of hotels that are open now are still operating at a loss. Airlines and hotels, the only reason they're able to operate is because the U.S. government gave them some bailout money. They did not bail out the cruise lines because they were foreign flagged. Loss of revenue to the U.S. This also affects us in the state of Florida. We get a lot of our revenue from tourists, and when they're not paying the bills, hey, our taxes could go up. So a lot of lost revenue to the USA. So where do we go from here? Here's how we think that travel is going to start to open up. Right now, domestic road trips, people take those nostalgic trips that you've always wanted to go. Go visit the lakes, the national parks, the beaches, do some family travel. Then domestic air travel never really shut down. It's always been open. In fact, good news, the TSA reported the largest number of passengers, almost 1 million, that traveled on Labor Day weekend. That's the largest since the shutdown in March. Now, we're still about 70% lower than last year, but things are getting better. So more airline flights are available all over. Then we think that international air travel will start to pick up. Yeah, again, we've lessened that we are able to travel to foreign countries. They may not all want us there right away without quarantining or a negative COVID test, but we can travel. Then we consider a small group, leisure travel and tours will start. Cruising, right now cruising in the USA or North America is still banned until November 1st. Cruising is going around in other parts of the world. We'll talk about that. But cruising will start to open up. Then business travel and small group meetings under 50 people. And then hopefully by the end of 21, in the 22, larger business meetings and gatherings, events over 100 people. So still a long way to go. But positive news, the COVID vaccines are hopefully coming on here by the end of the year. Anyway, lots of hopefully some positive shout out. So let's talk about hotels. So hotels, villas, and residential hotels, those are probably your best bets to travel right now, where you have you want to limit the touch points, limit the service things. So villas and residential hotels, especially if you want high-end luxury travel, go to high-end villa. Limited service hotels are really the norm right now. So you have your app, you can check in, you don't have to see everybody, you're not going to get room service in a hotel anyway. You can also do RV and camping. So what to expect if you go to a hotel? Usually you check in, you're going to have optional housekeeping services. They'll ask you if you want housekeeping or not. If you're there a couple of days, a lot of people don't want it. You can go pick the towels up at the front desk. And when somebody checks out, they call that room to be rested, that the staff will not go in there for a day or two to protect the staff. Now, easy to do this because hotels are running 25%, 30% occupancy if they're lucky. Maybe on the weekend, some of our beach resorts are running 80 to 100%, which is great. No room service or limited food and beverage. Limited bellman service and valet parking. No group activities. You want to use the app if you're traveling. Now, everything is on your phone app. So you want to download that phone app. You can check in on the phone app. You can check out. They even have a digital key service that we'll show you in this video about you can do on the phone. You can use the TV for that. You want to minimize your touch points. And so a little checkpoint, bring your disinfectant spray, your wipes, your Ziploc bags. You want to not touch everything. If you got go ahead and wipe down that remote controller, put it in a Ziploc bag. It's protected for you the rest of the time. Wipe down the doorknobs, thermostat, always wipe that down. That's something that we touch. Also all the sink handles and stuff. So what to expect? Hilton Hotels, along with every hotels, they're not talking about their bedding, okay, and the experience that they have. Their new corporate partners are Lysol and Mayo Clinic, all right? It's not PGA of America. It's not Porsche. It's not BMW. It's Lysol and Mayo Clinic. Why? Because we want to talk about how clean this is. You're protected if you stay with us. Pretty crazy stuff, right? Here's a little video from Hilton, kind of what you would expect if you're going to a hotel these days. Okay, so you saw that a lot of the hotels are doing that clean seal. That means that the last person, once the room is clean, it's been approved by the supervisor, they put that clean sticker on there. No one else has been in there. That's your guarantee of freshness. That's where we're heading nowadays. They also have the electrostatic foggers that can fog that room in a restaurant. You'll see them on the airlines as well in minutes. So all about cleaning standards here. Okay, airlines, what to expect on the airlines. They took a big toll, but they're coming back on here. So we had record numbers or the largest number since March that just happened. Great things on the airlines, they're waiving the change fees. The big airlines are doing that forever right now, so they say. Less occupancy, the planes are cleaner. So basically also what I want to talk about in travel, it's never been cleaner. Our airplanes, never been cleaner. Our hotels, never cleaner, never fresher. Theme parks that you'll visit, just not as many people on them. So we're the air handling systems in the airplanes, they've all been upgraded. The air, if you're on an airplane, the air gets recirculated every 2 to 3 minutes on there. Touchless travel, if you're flying, you wanna bring your app, you wanna download your tickets on that app, you'll check in on the app. You can also see what the occupancy on that app is too. So if you're on the plane, you see that it's full, you don't feel comfortable, you can get off that plane, book another flight. They're not gonna penalize you for that. So it's all about personal service, personal safety, making sure you feel good on that. Remember we talked about that real ID that you needed your license that was due with this October of 20, that's all been changed to October 21. If you can afford it, I'm not there yet, private jet service. Just wanna put it out to you. We do book those, but that is by far it. Forget about going through a dirty airport on an airplane. Go private jet service. If you can afford a private charter service, maybe go on your own RV, but that's what you want to go nowadays. Okay, here's a little bit on United, and guess who they partnered up with here? So they're part of Clorox in Cleveland Clinic. Partners are Clorox in Cleveland Clinic. So nowadays, if you're flying first class, I'm not sure it's totally worth it. You're going to get a larger seat. You'll be up front, but you're still getting your food in a bag, limited service on there. If you notice, everybody's bringing their own bags. You definitely have to wear a mask on board all the time. So let's talk about some strategies. Excuse me here. So, here's my flying checklist, and I can send this to you later if you like. If you're flying, you definitely want to book a nonstop direct flight. Window seats are always a little bit better. Arrive early. Always want to have your app when you're on when you're traveling. Don't do paper tickets. Use everything on the app. My personal recommendations: I wear long pants, closed shoes with socks, long sleeve shirts with pockets. If you got kids traveling, give them something where they can put their hands in their pockets. You're going to want to have your sanitizer, your wipes ready with you all the time when you go, your mask, try to avoid touching rails, doors, download your entertainment. Again, as much things you can have, food, drinks, snacks, bring those with you because you're not going to get too much on board. Also, they're taking your temperature everywhere now if you go on an airport. So don't fly sick, bring your medications. I have bad allergies, so I have to make sure when I fly now that I take my medication so I'm not sneezing everywhere. They'll kick me out of that flight in a minute or give me a lot of bad looks. You don't want that happening. So the world, again, is going to be safer. They're basically going to be taking your temperature almost everywhere you go. Think about if we continue this down the road here for schools, concerts, anytime you walk into a hotel, a trade show, they take your temperature. Sorry, sir, you got a long temperature. Maybe we need to isolate you. So the world eventually, I think, could be a lot safer, cleaner place on this. Wash your hands. And if you don't feel comfortable, cancel your flight. It's always your personal choice on there. Let's talk about car rentals here. Here's a pledge on this. This is what's happening for the car rentals. We'll do a short video on this.
Behind all this is our pledge to safety.
I pledge to take cleanliness to a whole new level.
I pledge to make sure 6 feet is really 6 feet.
I pledge to disinfect your car like it's my own.
That's the Avis Safety Pledge.
Okay, so that now they're not pledging fraternities or sororities. It's pledging to keep you safe. This is the mantra. This is the new normal in travel, guys. It's safe. Everybody's about safety. They're not talking about we got the latest luxury, newest cars. We'll get you to your counter out the door. No, it's about safety. They're pledged there for you.
So,
theme parks too. We'll talk a little bit about that. Then we've opened. We have great theme parks here in Florida. They've opened up. It's been safe. Have we heard any bad stories about theme parks? No. The news, unfortunately, always provides the bad news, but there's been great news. They've been opening up. My cousin was just at Disney a day ago, had a great time. So it's reduced occupancy. Everything's on the app. You want to make your ride reservations in advance. You can order your food and drinks on the phone. You have to wear a mask. They have certain areas of the theme park where you don't have to, but otherwise you have to wear a mask everywhere. All the staff are wearing masks. There's empty rows on the seats. So far it's been very, very positive, and we're moving forward on that. And here's a little information on what's going on at our friends over at Universal.
Finally, the time has come for welcome backs, glad to see us, and giant yet distant air hugs. It's time to see all those smiling eyes we love so much. But first, before the gates fly open and everything roars again, we need to do something. You and us together. We've always been about safety first, and that's never been more true than now. So for the health and safety of our guests and our team members, we've set up some straightforward safety protocols. The first part starts with you, before you even get to the parks or city walk. If you have a temperature of 100.4 degrees Fahrenheit, that's 38 degrees Celsius or higher, you will not be permitted to enter. So we're gonna need you to stay home until you feel better. When you come to visit, you'll need to wear protective face coverings. If you don't already have one, they are available for purchase. You'll need to wear a face covering throughout your visit, except for when you're in the water at your hotel pool. While you're at Volcano Bay, face coverings are recommended, except when you're swimming or going to and from an attraction. And here's something else to look for throughout your visit. All across the parks, you'll see these important icons regarding face coverings, temperature checks, hand washing, and social distancing. While you've been preparing to visit, we've been busy enhancing our all high-touch areas. When you get here, you can expect extra precautions like temperature checks for our guests and our team members before entering the parks or city walk. You'll notice signage, lots of signage, reminding everyone to keep washing their hands frequently. At restaurants, tables will be spaced, so we keep the right distance between groups. Speaking of which, you'll also see spacing guides, directions, and floor markers to help maintain social distancing requirements. In addition, team members will help assist with social distancing when needed. Next, while you're here, you'll want to use the official Universal Orlando Resort app throughout your visit. While not all attractions will be open, with the app, you will be able to join the virtual line experience at participating attractions. The app also lets you pre-order meals for pickup or to have them delivered to your table at select restaurants. The Universal Orlando app is the best way to bundle all the conveniences you'll need into one simple tool. If you don't have it, you'll want to download it. Please note the CDC advises that older adults and people of any age who have serious underlying medical conditions might be at a higher risk for severe illness from COVID-19. Guests should evaluate their risk in determining whether to attend. People who show no symptoms can spread COVID-19 if they are infected. Any interaction with the general public poses an elevated risk of being exposed to COVID-19, and we cannot guarantee that you will not be exposed during your visit. We appreciate your cooperation during this unprecedented time. Of course, there's a lot that's changed very quickly, but your awesomeness never will. So we can't wait to see your smiling face and hear your shouts of joy, even if they are all hidden under a face covering. Stay safe. We hope to see you soon.
So Universal has done a fabulous job. Some friends there, it's a little bit different experience, but if you want to get out, and especially people that have those passes, you can go out and see it. So next thing, let's talk about cruising here. Current status. Cruising in North America has been suspended since March 14th of 2020. That's when CDC put a no sail order for all ships over 250 passengers. Right now it's November 1st. Many of the cruise lines have canceled cruises until December and even well into next year. So in order for cruising to be open, we need approval from the CDC, the National Institutes of Health. We also need ports to be open. You can't cruise until you go to a foreign port. So we need Alaska cruises. We need the Canadian ports open. We need the Caribbean ports to be open. You also need flying around. So flying now has been up and running, but we need some of these ports to be open and operating safely. Believe it or not, cruising has just started in Italy Norway, France, and Asia. And there's also some river cruising that's going on in Germany. River cruising, those boats are a lot easier to get together. They're under 200 people. So think about a boutique hotel. So a lot easier to start cruising. Cruising just started in Italy. You may have heard, you may not have heard of that. The first cruise ship just went. It was 6 days. It was for Italians visiting Italian ports. You had to stay in the bubble on that, and it went really well. They actually had to be on the shore excursions with the cruise line. If you left that, they knew that you didn't leave it because they were wearing a wristband, and they denied boarding some. So it's been great. We're learning a lot about cruising. So here's the new things that we think are going to happen. Protocols are not all announced yet by the Cruise Line International, but when cruising does take place, our major cruise lines that you deal with, Royal Caribbean, Celebrity, Norwegian, they're all Carnival, Princess, we're all going to be united. They're going to have the same cleanliness standards. They don't want to come out and say one's cleaner than the other. They're going to have similar standards on that. So the buffets will still be there, but they'll be full service buffets. Someone will be serving you the food along with the coffee. So you still have access to all that. Boarding process will be on the app. They'll have staggered self-distance. Pre-boarding medical questionnaires, you'll have to do all that. They'll take temperature checks every time you come on and off the boat. You'll wear masks during boarding, congested areas. Updated HEPA filters. So everybody's updated their air handling systems. Again, if you cruise now, you really want to have a balcony so you get that fresh air. They're going to be opening the windows a lot in the indoor areas, but they've also spent a lot of money on their air handling systems with these filters that basically have such a small little filter that they can go ahead and get, sorry about that, but on the filter, it will block any of the coronavirus on that. So there's more sanitation stations and cleaning. The crew will be tested regularly. Muster drills. And also going to be testing on board with a more robust medical staff and facilities. Now, if you do travel, highly, highly recommend travel insurance, especially if you're going international. Protects against unplanned events and circumstances, medical coverages, cancellation coverages for cover reason. The best policy is to cancel for any reason. So if you're traveling, you don't want to lose your investment. Cancel for any reason, that will cover you in a pandemic. Normal travel insurance did not. You must purchase cancel for any reason insurance policy, usually within 14, 21 days of your trip. It will reimburse you 70-80% of the trip costs. Again, that's a whole another session to talk about travel insurance, but you want to buy that now for any major trip that you're doing to protect yourself and your family. Here's a quick travel checklist we put together. You want to have wipes, masks, disposable gloves, disinfectant spray, food, drinks, and snacks. You want to download all the apps. A selfie stick, bring that every time you go on travel now. Don't hand your phone to anybody and get germs on them. Bring your selfie stick. Medications, bring those with you. If you took a recent COVID test, you need that to travel to certain parts of the, even some states in the USA, also some different countries. Make sure you have that with you or your antibody test. Ziploc bags to put everything in. Patience and flexibility. Pack that. It's a different world right now. Arrive early and try to use one credit card whenever possible and book refundable, flexible travel. The only constant right now is really change that's going on. If you're traveling, you need to eat indoor, go check the restaurant inside to make sure you feel safe. There's social distancing. If they're not, go try another restaurant or try some takeout that day. So trips you can take right now. You can go to lakes. We just did a couple great itineraries over to the Dakotas and Mount Rushmore and Yellowstone and Wild Bill Hickok territory. In South Dakota, there is no social distancing. You don't need masks. Private villas, those are fantastic. Go to a beautiful private villa. We have villas that you can have up to 30 people. So you can do a family reunion there. You can hire your own chef. You can be on a beach, on a mountain. Great time. RV travel. We've never rented some more RVs this summer. That's been very popular. Go do your own trip. You can charter a private boat. Just limit your exposure for the time being. Be prepared to quarantine if you're traveling international and have a recent negative test. Now more than ever, it's very important to use a travel advisor. You don't want to travel a place and get stuck there. You want to have your personal travel advisor, your travel coach. Situations change constantly with the COVID travel requirements. A travel advisor will help you with all that. Plus, they'll help you book refundable fares to get you if your trip is canceled. Things are changing all the time. The last trip we booked for someone, the flights changed three times before they got there. So a little flexibility, have an advocate, have a coach on your hand, use a travel advisor. It won't cost you anything more, and it'll save you money in the end run. So hopefully this is helpful information. Wear your mask, practice social distancing. If everybody does that, that's going to increase consumer confidence for everybody. We all want people to travel safely. If you see that at the destination, it will be great. Appreciate your support of that hospitality industry. One last little crazy video here to kind of motivate you. This is by the United States Travel Association.
Someone once said, life is what happens when you're busy making plans. But the truth is, in a life without plans, nothing really happens. So let's go there. Let's make some plans. Let's feel that feeling once again. The rush of excitement as you search and imagine that perfect getaway. Trip. Vacation. Let's go there. Somewhere. Anywhere. Let's save a date, book a flight, and get to the destination that will feel like no other. Because when the time is right, when the heart says go, we'll be ready. So let's book a trip. Let's aim for the horizon and shoot for the moon. Let's go there.
So thank you, everybody. Appreciate that. Get out and travel. Anticipation in travel planning is half of the trip. So if you don't have a trip plan, go book something, whether it's to the park, to the theme park, to the other side of Florida. You're going to feel a lot better. People love travel planning, whether it's looking on the map, looking at their what restaurants they want to go to, but it will make a huge difference for you guys. So I will stop sharing my screen now and happy to answer any questions that you may have.
Yeah, Dan, we actually have one in the chat box right now.
Okay.
And it says, what happens if you're on vacation and on a cruise and reboarding from a day trip and you have a temperature and not allowed to board the ship?
Okay, great. That's a great question, Gary. That's why you want travel insurance, okay? And that's where you want a travel advisor. So you've got to be careful on that stuff. You don't want to travel sick. So if you have a temperature, generally right now, they're going to allow you to get, it depends. Cruising's not operating right now. So if you're cruising on these ships that are operating, they probably would want to test you for COVID. They probably would let you back on the ship. They would quarantine you to your cabin, and then they would test you for COVID right there. That would work out. But right now, we are getting those quick COVID tests, so they'll definitely test you for that. But they would isolate you to your cabin right now. That's actually happened in cruising before COVID. If you were sick, because they don't want to spread anything, they would isolate you to your cabin. They actually know when you're going in and out of that cabin, believe it or not, from your keys. A little scary, so they can tell that if you're leaving or not. But you don't want to spend your cruise vacation inside, so don't travel when you're sick. Bring your medications with you. So I hope that answers your question. New requirements, Royal Caribbean and Norwegian Cruise Line got together. They've hired a lot of very interesting experts to talk about what's going to happen with cruising when they open up. They haven't announced all these regulations yet because cruising's just not back there. So why announce everything when it's just not up and running yet? But definitely, like if you're doing that muster drill, remember we all had to get together on board, that's going to change. That's not going to be a big gathering of people. You're simply going to do that on your phone app with a muster drill. So lots of the changes on there. Any other questions on here?
You know, Dan, so I had a question, and I saw some of your videos. Are you saying like the Marriott app now, all of that, the room key will be on there. You can control your remote things from there. Is that how those apps are going to be working at?
So good question. Yes. So before COVID, Marriott, Hilton, Hyatt, a lot of the big companies, Continental, had apps. Now they did it a lot of times, honestly, to save money. So you can make your reservation on there. You could check out. I mean, it's been the best thing in the hotel industry because you get on your app, you check in the morning. They say what time you're going to arrive at 4 o'clock or I'm not arriving till 8. Bingo. We know in the hotel business, you're arriving at 8. We don't have to have that room ready for you at 3. We can give it to Joe Smith over here who's checking in early knowing that we have a room for you at 8 o'clock. So those apps were available before, but they've been even better now. You can actually do on a lot of these apps what they call a digital key. And that key, you can go in, the locks on a lot of these hotel rooms are digital. You put your your phone over that lock, it'll let you in. Now, the only issue about that, or the con on that, is you're only allowed, it's only on that one phone that you'll have that key. If you have multiple people staying with you, you have to go get other keys for them. But yes, you can go in on that key. You can actually program it now to do your remote TV on there. You can order your room service or food, whatever food they're serving on there. So the app has got really, that's going to stay with us. I think it's a great thing. And it's all part of this touchless, you know, service for the most part.
That's amazing. Thank you. So we actually got another question. It says, this is from Robin. She's planning to fly to Atlanta this month. Will she need proof of a recent COVID test?
So Robin, great question. It changes all the time. I'm not sure about Atlanta. I have a link on my website that tells you what's open, what changes. I'd love to give advice on the fly, but it changes all the time on that. I don't know in Atlanta if you needed a COVID test or not on that. That I know in New York, you needed a COVID test, or actually they're just making you quarantine. Quarantine is only 10 days now. It's only 14. I have a link on my webpage. If you go to topgrouptable.com and go down to info and resources, and I can send it out to everybody, and that will give you the updated list, or pull up the Georgia Health Department of State, or State Department of Health, or whatever their health department, and they should tell you if you need one. I haven't heard it much in Atlanta that you need a COVID test, but good question.
Okay, I have a follow-up with that. I'm flying to Atlanta, renting a car for Avis, which was, thank you for that. I'm one of those people who believe in the mask and the wipes and the hand sanitizer, so I'm there already. The question is I know when you going from Atlanta to Alabama, at one time Florida was stopping people who had a New York tag, you know, and tell them to quarantine. When you quarantine for 14 days, I'm planning on coming back Monday. I've always wondered about that, and I told my husband, with us traveling to Alabama, Georgia, or North Florida, if somebody asks us to quarantine for 14 days, that's crazy. You can't quarantine for 14 days. So how is that usually handled?
Well, I haven't heard of, so how that's handled is they, you know, again, we're not doing that in Florida. That's all been stopped here. So you're not gonna have an issue driving back to Florida in your car. That's all been stopped. But say you went up to New York, they definitely have a quarantine up there. They would, at the airport, you're from Florida, okay? So they would ask you, where are you staying? I'm staying at this hotel, or I'm staying with this family. They will take your information. They will follow you and see where you are going. If you're supposed to be in quarantine, don't be crazy on social media that you're out and about at the beach. And they will have contact tracers, and that's what they do. They will check in you if you're at the theme parks and ride around talking to Mickey Mouse, everything else. So they do check on you. You're supposed to stay in that spot if for certain, it's only 10 days now, it's not 14, certain states. But Florida's not like that. I've not heard anything about Alabama. Atlanta, I've not really heard that either. I think you should be fine. You know, go on. Again, I have a link on my website that lists all the updates. It changes constantly, but the world is getting a lot better now. We're starting to see a lot less quarantining than before. Now, I think you should be fine on that for the most part, but definitely double check. That's the key. You want to check your hotspots. Being a smart traveler, or a good traveler is a smart traveler, check everything you can. There's some links on there that will help you with all that for sure.
Thank you.
I think the two questions that just came in from Roz and Wendy, they related to quarantining in New York and New Jersey. So I guess I would redirect you to Dan's website to check those quarantine restrictions.
Yeah, and I haven't heard if you're driving that they're actually stopping you. And I, you know, it's like Florida, you know, they were eventually, sometimes we were stopping some people, but if you're driving on 95 or the big roads, take a smaller road in, you know, into the city. If you feel about that, maybe you'll get some local information on that. You know, go at night. I haven't heard all this that in New Jersey they're stopping you at the border or New York. So things are starting to lessen up a little bit. But it is a real thing out there, yeah. It is 10 days. Most of the CDC has said you really only need quarantine for 10 days. The virus is only active for 10 days, not 14 days. So that's been lessened now. Check the CDC as well. They have a really great website. It's updated all the time. They go state by state on there as well. We have a link to that on our website as well on there.
Great. Any other questions for Dan? And well, with that, I'd like to thank you. This was a very informative presentation, a lot of great information. I'm glad that it's being recorded so other people who missed it have the opportunity to go back and watch that on YouTube. It provided a comfort level to myself. I've been a weary traveler in this circumstance, but the information you provided definitely would persuade me to dip a toe in the water.
Well, and if everybody here could do me a favor, when you do travel, go take pictures of yourself traveling, put it on social media, show yourself with a mask, spread the word. It's just consumer confidence. Everything is open. Everything's available for you. It's cleaner than it ever has been. We just need people to feel comfortable when you travel. And people are having great times. Unfortunately, they just show the negative stuff on TV. People are having wonderful experiences all the time. So share your around, wear your mask though in public. That's gonna give other visitors to Florida, where we live, a chance to feel comfortable, spend their money down here. We wanna welcome everybody, but you know, spread the word. That's what we need. Unfortunately, you see the cruise lines are not spreading the word because they're just not cruising right now. We're like, why aren't you out there doing it? Well, we really have nothing to show. We're not cruising. The hotel industry, they've been working so much on safety that, and unfortunately, the national news likes to portray the bad stuff, but there's a lot of positive stuff going on there. So feel safe to travel. Reach out if you have questions anytime. We'd love to help you, but there's a lot of great resources and beautiful spots for you to go enjoy for sure. Or book a trip for next year when you feel more comfortable. It's always a personal thing, but book it now. Put some money into it and help support the leisure hospitality industry. They need your help out there. So thank you, everybody. Appreciate being here.
So thank you for spending your lunch hour with us. We hope to see you tomorrow morning at our breakfast. It's our Golden Bell Education Foundation breakfast. You can still register for that. And it begins at 8:30 tomorrow morning. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Bye.